and welcome to another edition of Guardians of Tears X-Wing Tournaments. This one is the Mario Kart. You may have seen the Hunger Games. I'm joined by Mr. Ian Wardle.
Hello there.
Now, you were the TO on the day.
Yes, I was.
Now, this is Mario Kart. So, yeah. if you can have a look at the screen, you can see that the start line is to the right of the screen. You can see the checkered line there.
Yeah,
and
wonderful.
Then you can see the other sort of taped off marks are the...
Obstacles,
yeah.
So you've got to race around them.
Yeah.
If you hit them, you can, as an action, you can rotate your ship, but you can't go through them.
No.
Unless you get a card that you can.
Lovely. Okie dokie. So, we have on the table today, we have Mr. Dave Cooney.
Which I think you've just seen him fly. He's got a sign on test pilot.
We have Ed...
who's got Cad Solace in a Fang Fighter.
And we have Chris.
Who's flying a Green Squadron A-Wing.
And Adam.
Who's flying Jake Farrell.
Okay, so as we go through the game, so you can see, look, the idea of the Mario Kart is to do as many laps as you can?
Well, this was just one lap to keep the time down, really.
Gotcha, okay. And then, but they're flying around, they're picking up tokens, which are missiles and bombs, or?
They're basically all sorts. So it's offensive stuff by the looks of things.
Yeah.
It's quite a while since we did we're now recording this 6 weeks after the event.
Yeah.
So you'll be able to see some crit tokens. That's where if you fly over one of them, you get the upgrade.
Right.
And once you've flown over, you then place that token within the rear guides of your ship.
Right, okay. Okie dokie.
And if you get destroyed, you go back to the nearest spawn point, which, as you can see, are in the corners or in the centre of the board.
Lovely. They're the blue markers that you can see there.
Actually, they're spawn symbols from the comic Spawn.
Oh, are they really? Yeah, yeah. Sweet. That's awesome. Okay, so here we go with Jake Farrell. So Jake Farrell is going to speed out there.
And as it's a racing game, you'll see that all those guys have all got the boost action.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's probably the best bet. And of course, with Jake, obviously, he's got the luxury that he does a spoon, a boost and a barrel roll, he gets the focus. Or he does the focus and gets the other from it.
That's it, yeah.
So that's worked out pretty nice for him. Now, the problem is, without obviously being out the front, is everybody else shoots at you.
There is that, but the PS thing is brilliant in this, because if you've got a low PS ship, you're going first. So you've got more chance of crossing the line first.
Yes, yeah.
Whereas your higher PS ships, they can see where stuff is, but they can get blocked fairly easy.
Yeah.
So although Jake's got a really amazing ability, actually in this, Sinar test pilot goes first. So he's got a big advantage as well.
Yeah. He blanked out.
So probably just one damage deck.
Yeah.
That's in the middle. And then I'll randomly generate the things from my iPad. I've got a randomizer and I just inputted all the cards.
Nice. Okie dokie. So we're back onto Sinar Test Pilot.
Dave had done pretty well. In his previous game he won with his Sinar Test Pilot. So he was quite confident going into this one.
So what game are we in the day now?
This is the last game of the day.
Gotcha, okie dokie. So yeah, so barrel roll or boost?
I think it's barrel roll. So you can
pick up the token.
So with that, Dave gets Dead Man Switch.
Dead Man Switch, okay.
Not particularly helpful.
Well, no,
I didn't say they were helpful, but
even if as close as they're going to be, Dead Man Switch, if someone does actually take him out, he can actually do damage back to him and then spawn again.
Yeah.
Quite close by, so it might work in his favour. Here we go, Green Squadron doing a big three.
Right,
I suppose you've got to think of the point of, I mean, I know he's boosting.
He's going for a boost.
But it's like, that means you might not have a shot, but you might block the higher PS behind you.
He hasn't actually got that token as well, that's just missed out.
Oh dear, okay.
But it's potentially blocking somebody else getting that taken.
Yeah. Here we go. So Cad Solus is moving up. What'd you do? Barrel roll there? To try and dodge this?
I think barrel roll would be the best one.
There we go. See? We've played this game before.
Yeah. And that blocks a potential hard one from... from Jake. I mean, Jake is looking pretty blocked there, whatever he's going to be doing. So, although in the main game you'd think that would be pretty good, in this one, with the people he's against, not actually that helpful at the moment.
There we go.
That's pretty casual. You know, nothing's... No exact measurements. It's all about fun. Oh, I'm going back. What's going on there? Oh. Oh, more precise thing going on.
Now they're thinking about that again. Yeah. Actually, I suppose what they were thinking was the arc. Will he actually fit?
Well, it should be range one of that test pilot as well.
Because the thing is, it's like, will he actually fit? And I'm not sure he would. Because obviously the angle of the ship, the back right corner might clip the Cad Solus. So if that's the case, he goes right back to the start. There we go. And then Jake slides back in.
And then Solus in the back.
There we go. So Solus has got a
pretty tight formation. That looks like Jake's shooting.
He's shooting sonar test pilots. He's only got the one. And Dave's on his defence dash.
That's it. He's dodged by the looks of things. He's dodged those. Cad Solus. One. Oh, it looks like a dodge to me.
Yep. Now back to the movement phase again. So if you're a sonar test pilot, do you just slow roll now? Because knowing that you've got the better race in line, if it was?
I think it's a race for tokens, really.
Yeah.
Get a decent upgrade. I mean, Dave's got the only upgrade so far. Not overly useful at this stage in the game, but... Potentially, if he did die there from Adam shooting, he'd have been dealing damage to all those other ships.
Yeah, that's it, yeah. And if
it's going to be that close all the way around, that's a pretty powerful thing to do. Oh, I've died, but I've just dealt a load of damage.
Dealt a load of damage, yeah. And also you've got to think of the point of, you know, if he gets everybody down to one hull, and he's the one at the back...
Yeah, he goes, oh, I'll let me shooting go until we get to the end.
Until we get to the end, there we go. I'll shoot that one to finish him, so I'll skip over him on the next turn because he's behind me now.
Here we go, looks like he's getting another upgrade here. And that one is Adrenaline Rush.
Adrenaline Rush, that's not too bad.
Yeah, because...
Have they got any red?
They got 4K.
Yeah. We've got a 4K.
That's about it, 4K. But it's pretty good that you can have 4K and then boost afterwards.
Yeah. Or even 4K barrel roll.
Yeah.
So it goes Green Squadron. He's boosting. Trans.
Cheeky. So he hasn't... Chris hasn't gone for the... he obviously went for that upgrade thinking he'd get it in the first turn.
Yeah.
In the first bit. But...
Cad Solus is moving now.
He's got that one, by the looks of things. Yeah. So Cad Solus, he gets Cool Hand.
Cool Hand. I like Cool Hand. Cool Hand on, what's his face? The gentleman, was it, gentleman at one of your NK tournaments, he took Tomax Bren with Cool Hand.
Yeah, he's been getting quite a lot out of that. It's
really
good.
Yeah, that is good. That's a good combo, that
on
is.
On the shuttle, on the bomber shuttle.
Yeah.
So he dishes it. I think he has Fleet Officer with Cool Hand and a couple of other bits.
Okay, so he's boosting round. So Cad Solus is bringing it round. Now, Adam could probably just...
Well, it looks like Adam's going to get that upgrade.
Yeah.
I would have thought. But he's got blocked.
Bumped again.
So that high PS has landed him in last place at the moment currently.
Yeah.
But he's got that upgrade, which is Ion Torpedoes.
Nice. That is nice. So
yeah, could get quite a cheeky shot from that.
Yeah. So the Torpedoes, did you have to follow the full rules? Target locks and...
Well, if you picked up torpedoes, I'd let them target
just,
lock.
You could just target lock with it.
Yeah. So the format for this is if you pick something up, it's legal on your on your ship. So yeah, so if you had a TIE fighter, for instance, and you picked up iron torpedoes, you'd be out of target lock to get
to get
your torpedoes off. It just made it, it's just for fun.
Yeah, that's it.
But at the same time, get some crazy stuff on the board.
Here we go, look. So in our test pilot's got range one.
Got
a
shot. Two.
He's got two.
I think he dodged that, did he? Yeah.
Looks like it. And we are back to dials now, so here we go. So sign our test pilot first. Now this is a bit tricky, this manoeuvring around that, because obviously he's got the green squadron there.
Yeah.
So yeah, he's having to go take the wide angle to try and get round.
He's got to go for a boost in there, I would have thought, there.
Pushed him out a bit far, but...
Is he? What's he doing?
Yeah, he's boosting. So he's pushed him way out right. That's not such a bad thing. But the problem is you've obviously got, on that left-hand side of the screen, as you can see, there is a line coming in, an obstruction coming in from the middle, so...
Yeah.
Green squadron. Look at Chris. Look, Chris is proper out in the lead.
Well, he got in front, and he's just manoeuvring and blocking.
Yeah, he's still not got no upgrades, yeah.
Suppose if you're in front, you don't actually need upgrades.
Because the thing about the day was, you had 42 points.
42 points, and you had to buy two ships.
Yeah.
Which were not the same.
Yeah.
So it had to be same faction. You couldn't have anything with nine that could take nine hits.
Yeah.
So, or anything that would have five dice at range one.
Gotcha.
Because that'd just be too ridiculous. Yeah. You'd just go,
And nothing with advanced slam.
Yeah.
Yeah. Spamming them K-wings.
Yeah, I mean, like the advanced slam would spoil the format, both formats, Hunger Games and Mario Kart.
Yes, yeah.
But that kind of left out the TIE Punisher as well, that was also got a boost. It can tank its way round.
Yeah. So that was Jake Farrell shooting at Cad Solas, but Cad Solas blocked it. Cad Solas hasn't got a shot. Sinar Test Pilot has a shot on the green. So it looks like just the one.
He's fine.
Yeah, and he's dodged that. Problem is, once you get a boost in ship, it's you got to look at it from the point of view of majority of them are two dice attack.
Yeah.
So you kind of like, because A-Wing, Sinar Test Pilots, what else you got? TIE Bombers, they've got a boost, didn't they?
Yeah.
The only T-70. Thing you come, T-70, you've got three dice.
Yeah.
But then they come expensive. Interceptor, three dice.
Inquisitor.
Yeah, comes expensive, but he's got three dice.
25 points, it still leaves you 17.
17, so what could you have? You could have another TIE Fighter. Or Sinar Test Pilot with nothing on it. I think there's 16 points in it.
Yeah, TIE Striker wasn't out yet.
No, that's right.
So, I mean, that would be awesome in this, wouldn't it?
Yeah, oh God, yeah.
But it has to be naked.
Yes, yeah, so you haven't got the adaptive ailerons.
No. Yeah, that's quite important. All ships are naked, so no titles, no nothing.
Yeah. So there we go.
That's another one.
Avoiding that middle.
So that's Chris, he's just picked that one up.
Yep.
And that is advanced homing missile.
Cool. That's range one, isn't it? Range one, five dice.
2-3, isn't it? Advanced. No, it's just two. Range two is the
range
deal
two,
of crit.
Oh, it's the deal to crit. Yeah. Which can be quite brutal when you're looking at, you know, A-Wings and TACs. So. There we go. So that's... just a one banky banky and a boost. Try and bring him back in line. Jake is literally at the back of the pack.
Yeah, Jake is not doing very well there. Considering he won the Hunger Games pretty well by just boosting straight in there, getting as many upgrades as he could.
Yeah.
He's now getting blocked out of the party. So you can see where the different ships make a big difference in the two different games.
Yes. Yeah. What might be good for Hunger Games, so something a bit more powerful, a bit faster, excuse me, would be good in Hunger Games.
Mm.
And then in this, it's all about manoeuvrability.
Yeah.
You know, so...
But, like, Adam's other ship was just a Z-95.
Yeah.
Which he had no intention of using for...
Any of the games?
Any of this. Well, the first two games, all players used both ships.
Right, gotcha. There was
three players on each map.
Yeah,
so still six ships.
Yeah.
And on this, there was quite a few people elected to send their duff ship backwards around the course.
Right, yeah.
Which was crazy. But it looked amazing on the start line, six ships all heading off.
There we go, just the one. Yeah, it looks nice defended.
So ooh, that's a good roll. Three. It's blown up. So he goes back to the nearest previous spawn point, which is the corner. And he does that straight away. So the bearing there is...
He's like, come on, Adam, move all your crap out of the way. So he's... Still got to shoot, so he can shoot a Jake.
So he immediately goes back there, because if the next person dies and they can't fit on the spawn point, they go to the next one back.
Oh, I see. Oh,
so that's really harsh. Get screwed over. Yeah,
man, that's harsh. Oh, I took a damage. Oh, I took a damage. Chris is out way out in the front.
Yeah. I mean, it's only one lap, and he's fair way out from the other from everybody else now.
Can you shoot through the obstacles that you've put there as the walls, or are they?
Yeah, they just count as obstacles for shooting purposes.
Gotcha.
It's just movement. It was really intended for, so that people actually have to go around the course rather than I'll just fly through that.
Where's obstacle. He going? Where's Dave going now?
I think he's on a spoiling run. He's going to try and race backwards to kill Chris.
Is that what he's going to try and do?
I don't know. Look, that might be it. He's got... What did he have? He had adrenaline rush. Maybe he's looking to get something, a missile or something like that off. If he can pick something up.
And then he's got to come around and just he's getting across the finish line. Blap, blap. See you later.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
So Cad gets another one. So that is Moff Jared. So he's going to sit in there and just chuck him out of the airlock instead of getting him a
crit.
Yeah, ejector seat.
That's not too bad actually, especially on something that's just hull.
Yeah, big Goldfinger style. That.
Yeah, that's it. No, Mr. Joff Gerard, he's Richard today. Did you ever see the explanation of Moff Jared?
No.
How it works. Well, you take intel agent. It was a podcast, Kessel Run, and they did a thing and they said, you know, you're Moff Jared, imagine your first day, you're ringing all your parents and everything, saying, oh, I'm the new intel agent on the new, decimator kind of thing. And you meet Moff Jared, you shake his hand and he goes, well, I'll just take you to your office. And you go, okay, cool, cheers. And take you down and, This look like takes you. He goes, this looks roughly like an airlock. He says, no, we've converted it. It's fine. It's your new office. Well, why is there only a chair in it? No, that's fine. You just sit there, mate. Look out the window and let us know if anything's happening. You know, of course, you know, he sits there. He's like, rings his wife. He says, oh, yeah, I'm in my new office, yeah. Moff Jared goes, nope, see you later. Presses the button.
Chuck you in the way of that proton torpedo that's coming.
Sit in front of the ship and catch that missile as it's coming. Here we go.
Dave's on a, he's on a motor, he's motoring back there.
Treat Chris is like, I can't believe you're going to do this to me. He's pretty close though, isn't he? Look at it, he must smell,
he's
he must
just
smell the,
round there.
The finish line. He must be like, oh, I should be alright.
Oh, he's just picked up another one. So Chris has picked up Adrenaline Rush.
Adrenaline Rush. Which is not too bad on a... I think I need red. I need the K-turn.
Oh, the K-turn, yeah. It's a big one, isn't it? Is it a five or is it a four?
Five,
well, K-turn. They got both.
They got three and a five. So you can just imagine, so he's gonna try and... do you know what? If I was him, I would finish in style and K-turn across the line. Imagine missing it, though. 5 millimetre.
And then completely lose it.
Yeah. And then Dave comes up behind you and smashes her. Oh, Katsonis is on the chase.
He's not far away, really.
No, he's caught up well.
Big catch up.
I think Chris had to do a lot of manoeuvring to get through the top there.
He's just picked one up.
Yep.
So that is lightning reflexes.
Lightning reflexes. So he can flip round when he wants to.
Yeah.
Nice. So
any move he likes and then...
Flip
around. Yeah, 180.
Yeah, not sure that would work. Not sure how that would work. Why would you want to flip round?
I don't know. Get round one of them. I don't know.
But, oh no, he's actually behind me, just in front of the finish line. I've got lightning reflexes. It's a one use card.
That's it. All these upgrades are all one use. Upgrades.
All one use.
Yeah. Basically trying to keep him with Mario Kart.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
So instead once of banana use it, it's done.
Katsonis firing.
Whether they were actually useful in the game, that was a completely different matter altogether.
Yeah. Here we go. Look, he's coming for it. He's coming for the spool spore.
You can hear the Jaws music almost.
Yeah, but he's humming it to himself.
Come on, Dave, boost.
You know you want to boost, Dave. Probably, I mean, if Chris does a hard two right, he can probably clear that.
There he goes. Oh, well.
He's trying to edge his bets on an arc. And then obviously, he's going to boost. Nearly there. Do it. He's like, go on. Think you want to. He's thinking I'm gonna ruin Dave's party here. Well, he's come back for a kill shot. You can see it, can't you? He's looking at him like,
imagine if Dave was able to shoot Chris, but he missed, and then Chris shoots Dave and kills him.
Yeah, that's it. You'd be like, I'll teach you.
Just to add insult to injury.
Well, the thing is, Chris shoots first. Here we go.
No, I think Dave shoots first.
Sign our test pilot. Barrett. Yeah, he's a two.
Yeah.
And he's not a prototype. Is he green
squadron? Oh, yeah, he's green squadron. Right, he does shoot first. Oh, what is that move that Ed's done there? Ah, what he's done there is he's picked up a proximity mine and it's blown up. So there were booby traps tokens.
Oh, well. Really? Oh, okay.
And he rolled
That's
two
cool.
hits.
That's cool. I like that. Booby trap tokens. Okay. Now he's got a shot there on Jake. So if he gets his shots in good, and Dave gets his shots in good, Chris might not even have a chance to cross the line.
So there we go. Jake has just picked up Dead Man's Switch.
Dead Man's Switch.
Yep.
So who else has got? So he's got Dead Man's Switch. What's Dave got on his?
Dave's got Dead Man's Switch.
He's got Dead Man's Switch as well.
I think that's already gone off because he blew up.
That's right. Yeah. But there was nothing around him, was there? I don't think.
No. An adrenaline rush.
Oh, look at that, look, two hits.
I believe he picked up crack shot somewhere along the line as well.
Oh no, Katsolus.
But he didn't actually go back that far.
I didn't go back that far. Thing is though, can he point it in any direction?
Yeah,
he can. So he can actually have a shot back at Adam's Jake.
And then send him back to the...
And send him way back. So here we go, corner. This could be a big thing. Let's have a look. Oh yes! Oh yes! There we go, Jake has to go all the way back to the corner.
Brilliant.
That is awesome.
Chris is having a pop at Dave.
Chris is saying...
So it's all kicking off.
You want to mess up my party, so nothing. So Dave's going to shoot back. Oh, yeah. That looks like two. Oh, that's enough. That's enough.
He's all right.
Yeah, he's fine.
He's done it then, hasn't he?
So it looks like, yeah. So
unless Dave can block him somehow.
Are they going to go... Should we put in? or Adam's going to take 15 minutes to choose his dial now. You want it, I'm going to make you earn it.
He hasn't lost though. Dave's the one who's lost. He's gone the wrong way.
No, that's, yeah, good point. And they shake hands with Chris because Chris has decided that he's won. Right, okay. Well, thank you very much for joining us and we'll speak to you soon.
Hope you enjoyed it.